David Heyman, who produces the Harry Potter movies, had optioned Danny's book, Yes Man. And Nick Stoller, who directed Forgetting Sarah Marshall, wrote the first draft. So I read Nick's draft and then went back and read Danny's book. And I love the idea that Danny had actually done this in real life. And, you know, you could clearly see that there was a great idea for a movie there. So Jim was involved in the movie, and we sort of set out to, you know, to work together with the writers and figure out how to adapt Danny's book. But the core idea of that book is really what attracted both Jim and myself to it, because it's a really cool idea. Again, we liked that it wasn't a magical conceit. It was just something that a guy, anybody could do in real life. Well, Jim was involved from the beginning, which was one of the things that attracted me to it. And Jim's really great because, you know, he had done something, you know, he had done Liar Liar, and there's something about that situation that really plays to Jim's strengths, sort of a situation where all common sense is telling you one thing, but you have to do another. But it was important to Jim and to myself that this be different in that, you know, there's no magic involved. You know, it's not like a curse or a spell or something. It's very grounded in reality. And we wanted to make a Jim Carrey comedy, but also to kind of situate it in the real world and have him play a real, relatable guy. Well, when Jim said, I don't want to stunt man, I'm absolutely doing the bungee jump, I had to go to the producers in studio and say, this is great. Jim Carrey, you know, our giant movie star wants to jump off a bridge. For me personally, it's great because, you know, it's the real actor doing it. How do you feel about it? They didn't feel really very good about it. They were worried about insurance. They were worried about, of course, Jim Carrey dying, not surviving. So they said, yes, you can do it, but it has to be the last day of the shoot. That way we have the whole movie in the can just in case something goes awry, which struck us as very morbid. It was hard to work on this movie, like for the cast and crew, and not have it, you know, filter into your personal life. You know, because you'll work all day long, kind of be exhausted and just want to go home. And then someone says, hey, the guys, we're going down the street and have a drink. It's like, you want to come? It's like, yeah, of course. And it always is something good. You know, it's like one of those things where you, it's a very sort of common issue where, like, once you're out, you're probably going to have a really good time. It's just jumping over that first hurdle. And that really was at the core of the whole Yes Man philosophy. But, you know, there's one of our writers came in one day and said, I did it for a whole day. I said yes to everything. He ended up going to some party that he didn't want to go to. He met this girl, and you know, a year later, they're still dating. So, you know, we made the movie just hoping people would laugh and have a good time. But in some of the screenings, people come up after and they say, like, you know, I'm going to try it, and I kind of, you know, I can kind of see a little bit of myself in that character, and I'm in a rut, and that's kind of cool to see that.